had seen the item category customizing. Today we are going to see the schedule line category. Okay. So I will let you know comfortable with what item category does for a sales order. So let me create a sales order. So what does a schedule line contain basically? Dates, okay, and the quantity. Yeah, correct. Okay, so the schedule line contains the date and the quantity, and in case of partial delivery the system creates more than one schedule line, and each schedule line is converted into a delivery. And this is the schedule line that informs the MRP department saying that I have got a requirement of so and so pieces, so you have to arrange for that whether through production or purchasing. So you are transferring the requirements to MRP department through schedule line. And second thing is, how does the system arrive at the schedule line? It does something called as availability check. When you say that I need a delivery on particular date, that date is taken from your sales order. If you see, you can see something called as required delivery date. So when you say a required delivery date, there are certain dates associated with that. For example, time taken for transit, time taken for doing the goods issue, time taken for doing the picking and packing activity. So the system calculates everything from this date and then says okay. Then it finally comes to the material availability date in your plant, and it carries out the availability check and says okay, on this particular date I have the quantity requested by you, so I can confirm it. Once it confirms it, it creates a schedule line. If it is not able to confirm the full quantity, it will go for further, it will go for additional schedule line based on certain parameters. You will see that now. Okay. So you only your schedule line says what is going to be your, whether an availability check is being carried out or not, and whether the requirements is transferred to MRP department or not, and what kind of movement it is going to have. Movement type we had seen, like whether it is going to be a goods issue or goods return, or there are many things. Okay, so let us as of now, whether it is a goods issue or goods return. So only based on the schedule lines, the system creates a delivery, and the quantity and dates are taken from the schedule line. So let me see here. I select this line and go to the schedule lines. It is having the quantity and date icon. Okay. System says on 8th it is able to confirm. So let me select this line and go into further details. Here CP is my item category. CP is my schedule line item category. I select and go. It says okay, on 8th the system, you have asked for 10 pieces and the system has confirmed that piece. Okay, confirmed quantity is 10 here. For shipping, how the system confirmed, okay, on 8th this delivery can be made, because it had done certain things. The material is available on 3rd. Okay, which means, okay, for example, it is not, most of the time SD handles, the kind of goods SD handles, it's not the something you can pick off the shelf and walk on. Okay. So it has certain activities. For example, there will be sometimes, let me say, complicate the thing. Sometimes, let me say there is a machinery. This machinery is so bulky and it cannot be handled manually. So you will need a special cranes or forklifts or any other handling equipment to carry that. Okay. So first your handling is based on your handling equipment availability. And second thing, it is so bulky and the packing it, removing it from the storage or production facility to the some common yard and then packing it, it is going to take some time. Okay. Once you have done this, once the packing is done, this has to be lifted and placed on the transportation vehicle. Okay. Or it has to be stuffed into the container and the container has to be transported, placed on the long vehicle. Okay. So this has to be done based on the availability of the user, overhead crane or forklift. Okay. That is why the loading date, everything is having a considerable time, which means even though your material is ready and available on 3rd of August, to load it will take 1 day. Okay. Then you have to prepare your documents, you have to prepare your gate passes and whatever things like quality certificate, certificate of origin, whatever it could be, all the legal documents. So to prepare that and then finally to send the goods goods out of your premises, that will be done on 5th of August. Okay. So if the goods leave your premises on 5th of August, it will reach the customer by 8th of August. So the system calculates all these dates and then only it says, okay, it is for the delivery can be possible on so and so date. On cash terms it didn't do anything because the customer comes in, he takes the goods on his own responsibility. So whatever this handling is being done, it will be done by them normally. So the system didn't calculate anything. But in case of an organized delivery, the system takes all these dates into consideration and then only it comes to the arrives at the delivery date. Okay. So you can see these dates in the shipping. These dates are what copied into delivery. If you go to, if you see a delivery document, you can see many tabs, picking tabs, loading tab, goods, planned goods issue date, and everything will be there. So these dates are copied from that only. Okay. And in case this article has to be procured by the MRP team, Metal Requirements Planning team, then the system will give the procurement details here. Okay. So these are all the data that are found in the schedule and tab of the article. So let me go and create another article, C-AT102, 10 pieces. Let me say that it has to be procured by the some other thing. So I am entering the item category as TAS. TAS is the third party item for which you have to write the purchase order. So what's happening? How the schedulings are enabled, because in the item category you have seen there is a checkbox called schedule lines allowed. Only when you enable the schedule lines allowed, the system will be creating the schedule lines when you go for sales order. Okay. So now this is ready and second will maintain this PR00. I am going to the schedule lines of this item. Can you see there is an additional button called as purchase requisition? For the item number 10, I don't have any purchase requisition. But for the item number 20, since I have said that it is going to be the third party item, the system has determined the scheduling category as CA and it has created a purchase requisition. So I can click the purchase requisition and see the details like, okay, so what is going to be in my purchase requisition? My purchase requisition type is going to be NB and I have requested on 28th and I expect the goods to be in my place on 2nd of August. Okay, I am going to order in pieces. So it is not saved, so the system hadn't given any number as of now. So the moment I save the sales order, the system automatically creates a purchase requisition for that. No, it's automatically created. It will automatically create a purchase requisition that has to be converted into a purchase order by the merchandiser. Okay, that is different. Okay. Let it save. Okay, let it save. Only now we can do anything. Other screen is also not there. Okay, so let me go on the change mode. That is a problem. If this is our newly created sales order, my second item is the TAS, that is having a different item category, which means it requires a purchase requisition to be carried out. So I select that, I go to schedule 9. I could see the system has created a purchase requisition. This has to be converted into a purchase order and will be delivered to the customer. Okay. So let us go and see the purchase requisition. So this is what the purchase there in the purchase requisition. So here, of course, based on your item category, okay, the system determines that this is going to be a third party item, but it is the first schedule line category that actually triggered the purchase requisition. If you see in the previous document type, I mean sorry, previous item, the schedule and category is CP, it didn't trigger any requisition. But the system determined the schedule and category as CF for this item and it triggered a purchase requisition. So let us see the configurations. So right now we had sent two schedule and categories. One is CP and another one is CF. Sales and distribution, sales, documents, schedule lines, different schedule line categories. So ours is CP. First one is the CP. It says like this must go for a requirement or assembly production. I mean, like we had seen just now, we had seen that in case of being sent to procurement or something, it must create a purchase order. Similarly, if it goes for production, then it must create a production order. Okay. Then it must carry the availability check. Only when it carries the availability check, then you will be able to confirm or confirm the quantity and date for the particular date. There is something called the product allocation functionality, and the schedule lines category supports the product allocation. So if you don't enable this also, it is fine, no problem. What product allocation is, so when sometimes it happens that some articles will be in shortage, or sometimes there will be a lesser production of that, okay, and there will be a greater demand for this, so everybody will keep asking that particular article or particular material. Okay. In such cases, you cannot give away the whole quantity to the, or you cannot give away the large quantity to the first come first served basis. Instead, you want to keep all your customers happy by giving to them everything. So, what you normally do is, you define something called as product allocation, and you say like, okay, for this customer, this month I will give 100 pieces. For my customer number B, this month I will give 250 pieces. Based on the their sales volume and based on your priority to them, so you allocate the quantity to them. Okay, so customer A will have only 100 pieces for a month. Customer B will have 250 pieces for a month. What happens is, when the customer A raises a sales order for this article, let me say he is raising for 50 pieces, okay, it will be delivered because it is below that 100 pieces. And if he raises a second sales order for 75 pieces, the system will create two schedule lines. First schedule line will be the year list available and it will confirm that 50 pieces. For that remaining 25 pieces, it will put to the first week of the next month, because the customer's quantity per month is, allotted quantity per month is only 100. He has exceeded this 100 quantity for this month, so it will push the remaining 25 to the next month. So this is how product allocation functionality works. Okay. If your schedule line wants to support it or not, that you can manage it here. Okay. And you have seen there is something marked as item allowance for delivery. Even though you had allowed schedule lines in the schedule item category, if you don't enable it as item allowance for delivery in the scheduling level, the system won't further copy, further create any delivery. Okay. So only when you maintain it here as allowance for delivery, the system will create a delivery. So till now you had seen that what are all the settings you had done for delivery in your sales activities. In your sales documents, you had said what is going to be the delivery type. In the item categories, you say that schedule lines need to be allowed. In case of text items, you explicitly say, force the system to have it delivered by saying item allowance for delivery. And you come to the schedule line categories. In the schedule line categories, you say that it is allowed for delivery. And this movement type only says, movement type is normally defined by among people. So, you don't bother much about that. But only thing is, like, you must know what are all the movement types associated with SD. One is goods issue. Goods issue is your normal delivery where the goods move from your plant to the customer. I only, like, in a layman language, you could say it is a forward movement. So goods move from your place to the customer. This movement type is 601, and we have something called as 651. 651 is for returns delivery. One second, can you move? The system is a bit slow. Okay, so till it comes, you'll see. There is something called as delivery block. So what happens when you create a sales order and create a delivery automatically, I mean immediately, the system copies the details. What happened? I am searching for sales order. Okay, since I am not sure of what my last order was, so I am clicking this button for order, and then reducing the search date. So let me say for 3 days. Okay, so 25/7, and I am choosing only my orders. If I don't give anything, the system will fetch all the orders created by all the users with the given time gap. So I am limiting it by my orders, and I can even say I can limit it by open sales order, which means the sales orders that are open, which are not delivered. Okay. We haven't created any delivery. So press enter for 1000 10 00. So this is what we created right now, 11790. EA02 11790. So this is what we are seeing, the schedule line, and in the SPRO we are seeing the scheduling category. Scheduling items at this. You are seeing the material type CV, sorry CP. Okay. And if I enable a delivery block here, the system will automatically create a delivery block in my sales order. The delivery block, you can see it in the, this is what. Okay. If you enable something here, so if you enable your delivery block in the schedule line, the system will automatically create a delivery block in the sales orders, which means you have to explicitly remove that and then create the delivery. Okay. This is normally to have a have authorization so that somebody verifies and checks it, then only create a delivery. So that is the delivery block. If you don't want to have a delivery block, you can leave it blank. But if you want to have a delivery block so that it has to be reviewed and then released, then enable it here. Okay. Movement type, that's what I said, like now. So what does this schedule line category do? This schedule line creates a delivery which makes the goods move from my premises to the customer's place. That is, the goods is my forward delivery, so it has a movement type of 601. There is something called as movement type one step. Okay, so as of now, let us not bother about it. But what movement type one step is, sometimes you send the you request a good to your vendor for a particular customer, which means your customer says that I need a, when you send me the goods next time, do one thing. So you pack it separately for me with my company paper or let me say, the normal comes in 100 pieces per pack. The customer is asking, do one thing next time, when you send the goods, pack it in 500 pieces per carton. So you pack it in that big carton and send it to me specially because this is my requirement. You pass the requirement to your vendor and the vendor is sending the goods. Instead of sending in 100 pieces per carton, he specially packs here 500 pieces per carton exclusively for your customer and sends it to you. You take the goods into your goods receipt and without checking into your stock, immediately you divert that direct the stock to your customer, which means when the goods are moving from vendor to your place, that goes for one movement type. Okay, and when the goods move from your place to vendor and customer, it has a movement type 601. But this time, it is not like you take into your regular stock and you do the picking activities and other things. You are moving it immediately to your customer, so it is a special activity. So in this case, for this special item or special article, you can map a single movement type, which means like for combining the 601 and the, I think that is 501, which comes in 301. So combining this 601 and 501, MM people, they can suggest a new movement type, which you can enter it here. So, I mean, for some SD point of view, you can do nothing in this. It has to be done in conjunction with the MM people. Then it says the order type. If the scheduling category creates any order, whether it is a purchase order or production order, that has to be populated here. And it says what kind of item category. This is a standard item, so I am leaving it blank. And account assignment category says to which account the revenue from this particular sale and this particular item sale must be posted to. Okay, once again it is a standard one, so let me leave it. Our next one we saw, this the one which we created the purchase requisition is CS. So let me click CS. Can you see in the CS there is no requirement or availability, which means it has to be it has to be sent to the customer. I mean, you have to procure it and then send it. So the system didn't carry out any availability in this kind of thing. Instead, it said you create a order type LD, that is a purchase requisition, and this item category is a third party item, and the amount must be posted to the third party sales. So this is how your schedule line categories work. Do you understand? Is it clear? Okay. So what are the item category determination? Yesterday we winded up our class with that. How the system determines item category? We have been for the same article, even in the same sales order, it determined two different item categories. I mean, yeah, that's what I say. For free item, it has a different item category. For normal item, it has a different item category. How the system determines that item category? No? Okay. Then? No? Then? There are four parameters I showed you. I even showed you how the system determines that. what will it? The system takes the item category for this combination of sales document type, which is coming from your sales order, and item category group, which will be taken from your material master sales organization to view. And usage, if usage is there in CMIR customer material info record, it will take there. And if it is a sub item of any item, then it will take the item category at the higher level. For this combination only, the system will determine the item category. So yesterday what we saw was my order type was OR, and what happened also is going to be different. Yeah. Some problem in connection to this. I think it's an internet issue. Because last time when I reconnected it, it said, connection is already established. Yeah, it seems the same again. /O. Sales and distribution, sales document, sales item, the same item category. So our document type was OR and the item category group was NORM, that took from the sales organization to view of material master, and there was no usage because I didn't take from my CMIR, and it is the first level item, so there is no higher level item for that. The system determined TAM, and when I had the higher level item as TAN, which means this article is the sub item of any article, the system gave TAMN. So this is how the system determined the item categories. The item categories are never hard coded for any article or any document type. Okay. It has to be determined for a certain combination. Only then the system will get you the, fetch you the item category. That is how even in the same document, the item category differs. Similarly, there is a determination for schedule lines also. Schedule line categories are found at the item level, so they are dependent on the item category. Okay. Then there is something called as MRP type. MRP type means it is a MRP type means it is material requirement planning type. How the planning has to be done. So let us go to MRP 1 and MRP 2. Now the MRP will be managed by materials management. So you don't bother about what are all those MRPs. But based on what is available, you can define your schedule and category. It says that is MRP type is PD. Here you can have something called as RP, that is replenishment planning, time series replenishment plan, auto replenishment. So when you have RP, what the system does, you maintain the safety stock. The moment, what is the safety stock? Any idea? Minimum inventory level you have to maintain. Okay, so at the moment the system falls below the minimum stock, the system immediately and automatically triggers a purchase requisition saying that it had fallen below. And there is another thing, why the system always creates a purchase requisition, why not a purchase order? And what is the difference between a purchase requisition and a purchase order? Okay, if that is the case, why can't I make the system to create purchase order directly? No, I have only one vendor. I have only one vendor for that article. Let me see. I have only one vendor. I don't have choice also. Okay. Normally, purchase requisition is a sort of wish list. You say like, I need or I expect this much of quantity or this much of article and pieces. That goes to the purchaser. There are many things happening there. One, the purchaser takes a look of your purchase requisition and either he can approve the your requested quantity or add or decrease. So sometimes he may say like, but this is a fast moving article, why you are requesting only 100 pieces? Okay, make it just 500. He can do that. Sometimes he says like, I believe you have overestimated the demand. It must not be 100, it must, let us make it as 50. He can do that also. That is one thing. And second thing is, like you, some other plans will also be sending the purchase requisition. Okay. So, it is not advisable to keep creating each sales order, multiple purchase orders for the same article to the same vendor. So what happens is the purchaser consolidates all these purchase requisitions and generates a single purchase order, sends it to the vendor, receives the goods, and based on your purchase requisition, he will split or dispatch the quantities to the client. Okay. So these are the two functionalities why the system always go for purchase requisition. But of course, making certain settings in the customizing, you can always make the system to create a purchase order directly, but SAP doesn't recommend that. Okay, so it always says like, okay, go for purchase requisition, and the purchase requisition is consolidated by, there is somebody separately designated for that. They are called as merchandisers or buyers. The buyer's role is only creating the purchase order and finding out the suitable source of supply. So that is why. So how the replenishment is done? It's done by either automatic replenishment, which means the moment this is the it follows. The moment system falls below the safety level or secure. Buffer level. In its term, we could use the moment it falls below the buffer or safety star, system automatically creates a purchase requisition. And there is something called as MRP, maintenance requirements planning. This is this is not automatically done, this is normally manually done. And there is something MD, no planning. There is no planning. So whenever somebody raises PR, get it replenished. Okay. If it is lying, if it is zero stock and nobody bothers about it, okay, the system won't bother about it. So that is what the activity of END. And there is something called as seasonal MRP. Seasonal MRP or forecast based planning. So your seasonal MRP, the system takes the past value. Okay, last year from the third week of, last week of July, the stock was at 100 pieces. Okay, safety stock was at 100 pieces. So this year also, for this last month of last week of July, system tries to maintain that 100 pieces. But last week of June can have a different quantity. So if the system falls below a certain value, until it falls to the certain value, system won't bother about it. But as of last week of July, the safety stock is 100, the system will take the 100 as the safety stock and create purchase requisition when it falls below 100. So that is the seasonal MRP. So since the item scheduling category communicates to the other department, whether it is purchasing or internal MRP who maintains the stock, or it goes for production order, so it normally takes into the MRP type also for consideration. Yeah. I am not sure. Yeah. I know that, but I am not sure about that. How it meets the value. So I go to the scheduling category determination, that is assigned scheduling category. The system takes into consideration of the item category as well as the MRP type. So what is our item category here? TA, N, and my item category is PB based on my MRP type of the article. How does the system determine CP? This is how it arrives at CP. If I am here, Yeah, we will assign here. And sometimes if a material requirement planning type is not available, then the system will determine a scheduling category purely based on item category. Here there is no material MRP type involved. So it is like 1-to-1 assignment. For this item category, this is the schedule line. Okay. But always the system will look for the item category and MRP type combination first. Only then it will go for your item category there. Okay, so this is how the system came. So what was our next one we saw today? It was CAS. Okay. My item category was CAS. Okay. And I don't know about the thing. So the system created a scheduling category of CAS. So this is how the system determines scheduling category. Scheduling category, I would say, manual scheduling category. So this is what system automatically proposes. If you want to have any alternatives for that, which you can enter manually, you can enter it here. For example, if I go to the scheduling category of my article, /NEA02-1790. This happens with even the item category also, not only with scheduling category, even with the item category also it happens. So let me say the system has proposed, but I can overwrite it here. But it's not that I can overwrite anything here. I can overwrite here with the combination I had given as alternative. So let me say what I had given for my TAN and CD, I have only given 2. I can choose either CP or CN. So let me see what happens when I try to overwrite it with CS. The system says scheduling category CS is not defined. If I press F4, I can see what are all the choices I have. I have only 2. Why only 2? Because that is the only alternate I have proposed here. This happens the same with your item categories also. I entered TAS manually, you remember? The system didn't propose. Even before the system proposed anything, I entered TAS and the system took. Because for this combination, I had kept TAS as one of my options. That's how the system allowed me to enter that item category. And scheduling category is the most underrated part of SD. Underrated and said it is most important, because on scheduling category level only you control your availability and you control, say, whether it is relevant or not. Only on the scheduling category you say whether it is relevant for delivery or whether it is having an availability check. Okay. If you disable those things in scheduling category, you won't be able to create a delivery in the first place. But not many people, not most of us recognize that those settings. So we normally we just copy. That is why even in the project what happens is, we will be changing the item category. In normally what happens in process, we are not supposed to use any of the SAP standards in the project, because let me say that I am using the TAM as my item category. So tomorrow somebody accidentally changes the parameters of TAM. Okay. Then the SAP standard gets changed, and if the user forgets to reverse the changes back, then it will affect the all the others. So what we normally do is, okay, we normally take a copy of this sales order, item categories, and here you are supposed to take the copy of scheduling categories also. But most of the time we don't do the scheduling categories copying, because we don't see that, because that is not in first screen. Okay. So we can always get away with that. Okay. So that is how it happens. Here. Okay. No, when you say that you are deploying for different countries, obviously your different countries is going to have different sales organizations. Okay. Hey, let the ECC be the single instance. It's going to be the single instance always. Just remember, it's going to be the single instance. Everybody is going to access the same production client. Okay. But based on your sales organization, you can make those changes. Yeah. Not in a sales organization. Let me say my Germany thing starts with 9,000. My Hong Kong will be 9,001. My India will be 9,002. Sales organization. So there it will be 9192 will be my distribution channel. Okay, so for this different sales area, that's what I say. If you go into the Metal Master on sales order view, sales view, you can find that you can have different base units of measure. You remember that now? Yeah. Similarly, for customer level, for each sales area, you can maintain in different currency. The same goes for purchasing also. So when they purchase in Germany, they do in Euro. When they purchase in India, they do in INR. Okay. So based on sales organization value, we can maintain this different value. So yesterday Kirisha was saying that she had created a new document type. Okay. So let me show you the item category customizing. I showed you the item category customizing yesterday, so we are not going to repeat that. and let me take TAM. TAM. Yeah, I am copying that item category. So my business says they wanted to say VSTM. Okay. Yeah. My business says like it has to be of some pricing. Okay, let me make it as normal pricing, standard pricing itself. Okay. In the ZTN level, let me say that it is not relevant for credit because I am not going to credit it. And let me say that I am going to do it based on my delivery related billing. Okay, so A, B, C, D elements you cannot create. So this is what there in SAP only. You cannot create this anymore. No, you cannot create this. This one you cannot create. A, B, C, D. What is relevant for billing? These things you cannot create. You have to use what is supplied also. Only. So let me say. So this is my standard item category. Which is relevant for copy control also. For this, and similarly, I am making another entry for three item. So let me say TANM. So in the three item, I am making a change. By default, the system says the three item is you quote the price and give a 100% discount. Okay. But my account is not saying if you take that way, there is some problem in calculating the entries. So make it as no pricing, which means the pre-pricing must have a zero price, not a full price and with a 100% discount. So they say they want a no pricing. So I am copying the standard free item. This, I should have copied that before making changes. I copy that ZTNL three item and mark it as junior three item. So my account people say that you make it as no pricing. We don't want the system to give price and then 100% discount. The price must be zero in the first place. Okay. And so I have made the changes. Now do you remember on what combination the item category is being determined? Just now we spoke about that. For what combination the item category is determined for? Which level? Higher level item category. Okay, one more. No, she had told three. She had told sales document type, usage and higher level item category. Only what is missing? Item category? We are determining the item category. How you can say item category again? item category group. Okay, so for that 4 only we are going to. What are this one we created? One is VSTN, okay, and VSFR. So I am assigning the item category. She had created a document type. Any idea what was? You guys also start creating your own document types, your own item categories, and make the system determine your item categories when you are using your document types. I don't get you thinking. Abhi, what is she asking? Okay. So let's do one thing. You copy something sales document type OR. I'm copying that. I'm making a new one. This is VSOR. I'm saving it. So whenever BSOR is being created as a sales order, the system must create my GSTN as item category. Okay. For free item, it must take GSFR. So here I am making a new entry. I am saying if my document type is GSOR and my item category group is NORM, which I took from the Metal Master. I don't have any different right now, so I am saying GSTN must be my. Okay. And I am making another entry. GSOR is my document type. NORM is my item category group. GSTN is my higher level item, for which I am going to give you a free item. So I am assigning GSFR as my item category. Okay, now I have saved it. Whenever you make any changes, those kind of changes, you come out of the screen completely, then only this database will be updated. I am coming out of the item category determination screen. Similarly, I am coming out of the document maintenance also. VA01, that is our newly created GSOR. No, just item calibration. Okay, take me for this value. Can you see what is the item category system is taking? It is GSTL. Okay. So let me enter C-AT102, which is going to be the three items for item number 10. So I am putting the higher level item, item number 10 as the higher level item. The system determines ZSXR. It's actually very simple. If you understood the concept, it's very simple. You have to maintain the entries properly. Okay. Yeah. It will be okay. Yeah. Why I maintain GSTN and why GSFR? Because, okay, for GSFR, my account department says, I don't want to give the complete price and give a complete discount. I want a zero price. So, let me go here. Can you see? There is no PR00 here. Okay, even if I enter a PR00, let me say 395. The system requirements are not fulfilled. So you don't need a PR00. Whereas for the previous item, I have to enter a PR00 because that sum only it will take the price. Okay. So this is how normally you will end up customizing in your project. So they will be saying like I need this, I need that. Okay. So based on that you have to do your customizing. Sometimes they will be saying like I want the item category to carry out a new pricing every time. So whenever it comes a sales order. For example, you have created a sales order today, but after it comes to delivery after 3 or 4 weeks. At the time your price would have been changed. So they will be saying like I want a new pricing to be carried out. Okay. So the setting lies in your item category itself. So you go to PAN. Okay, this is standard pricing. Okay. Now that setting will be in your document page. So they will be saying like copy the pricing elements and that has to be done through that code. Okay. So make yourself comfortable with item category and scheduling category, because from tomorrow we will start the other customizing activities like how the system must react if something is missing in the sales document. We are going to see the incompletion log tomorrow. Then we will see the partner determination. If possible, tomorrow we will see incompletion and partner, and then we will go for copy control. Once we have seen the all the sales document customizing, then we will go for delivery. Okay. Okay, practice. That's only thing I feel.